Hello students, we are going to discuss about population in the area of industrial crystallization. Population balances are used to model how the number and the properties of the crystal in a crystallizer are generated and eventually appear as the solid product. Population balance is a mathematical description of conservation of number of particles and account for how the number of particles having a particular set of properties, that is size, shape, density, etc., may change during the process. Population balance has the same format as a mass balance or energy balance. While mass and energy balance are conserved, particles having specific properties are not. Aim of population balance to account for how various mechanism lead to changes. Traditionally, population balance is a number balance, accounting for the number of particles of each particular size. Even though linear size is by far the most common particle characteristics on which the balance is based, other independent variable of the particle phase. Phase can be of interest and modeled. By particle phase, space is mean the multidimensional phase of various particle properties. Population balance can also be formulated with more than one independent variable describing different particle properties. Example, if two linear dimension of the particle are used in its characterization and are included in the modeling, we obtain a balance that also contains a description of shape changes, not only size changes. This is the examples of population balance model. Feed is entering into the process. This is supersaturation generation, evaporation, cooling and anti-solvent. Evaporation is nothing but the phase change from liquid to vapor. Cooling is nothing but reducing the temperature. Anti-solvent is a solvent in which your compound is less soluble. Usually solvent or anti-solvent mixture is a good component for obtaining crystal, especially in the case of organic compounds. Supersaturation. Supersaturation solution is in a metastable state. It may be brought to equilibrium by forcing the excess of solute to separate from the solution. Two type of the kinetics here. One is nucleation, another one crystal growth kinetics. Nucleation kinetics is nothing but rate of formation of a stable nuclei. Growth kinetics is nothing but rate at which a stable nuclei grows to a large crystal or macroscopic crystal. Changing the scale or mixing condition in a crystallizer can directly impact the kinetics of crystallization process and the final crystal size. So here crystallization or crystalline population coming out from a crystallizer is characterized by its size distribution, that is crystal size distribution, which can be expressed in different ways. crystallized distribution may in fact be referred to the number of crystals, the volume or the mass of crystal with reference to a specific size range, or the cumulative values of number, volume or mass of crystal up to a fixed crystal size, that is total crystal surface area, this is goes to supersaturation, then total crystal mass, this is goes to nucleation kinetics. So here suspension hydrodynamics. So the hydrodynamics of secondary nucleation in suspension crystallization, hydrodynamic models of secondary nucleus generation in mechanically agitated. So finally produce the product. Okay. Thank you for your attention.